Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today the Church celebrates the martyrdom of St. Charles Luanga and his 21 companion martyrs. Let us ask their intercession and prayer that we may also be steadfast in our faith. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge our sins and ask God's pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have made the blood of martyrs the seed of Christians, mercifully grant that the field which is your church, watered by the blood shed by St. Charles Luanga and his companions, may be fertile and always yield you an abundant harvest. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the second letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, may grace and peace be yours in abundance through knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. His divine power has bestowed on us everything that makes for life and devotion, through the knowledge of Him who called us by His own glory and power. Through this, He has bestowed on us the precious and very great promises, so that through them you may come to share in the divine nature, after escaping from the corruption that is in the world because of evil desire. For this very reason, make every effort to supplement your faith with virtue, virtue with knowledge, knowledge with self-control, self-control with endurance, endurance with devotion, devotion with mutual affection, mutual affection with love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In you, my God, I place my trust.
In you, my God, I place my trust.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust.
In you, my God, I place my trust.
Because he clings to me, I will deliver him. I will set him high on high, because he acknowledges my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in distress.
In you, my God, I place my trust.
I will deliver him and glorify him. With length of days I will gratify him and will show him my salvation.
In you, my God, I place my trust. Please stand.
Jesus Christ, you are the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead. You have loved us and freed us from our sins by your blood.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus began to speak to the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders in parables. A man planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenant farmers and left on a journey. At the proper time, he sent a servant to the tenants to obtain from them some of the produce of the vineyard. But they seized him, beat him, and sent him away empty-handed. Again he sent them another servant, and that one they beat over the head and treated shamefully. He sent yet another, whom they killed. So too many others. Some they beat, others they killed. He had one other to send, a beloved son. He sent him to them last of all, thinking, they will respect my son. But those tenants said to one another, this is the heir, come, let us kill him, and the inheritance will be ours. So they seized him and killed him and threw him out of the vineyard. What then will the owner of the vineyard do? He will come, put the tenants to death, and give the vineyard to others. Have you not read this scripture passage? The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes. They were seeking to arrest him, but they feared the crowd, for they realized that he had addressed the parable to them. So they left him and went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
All of us, at one time in our lives, have experienced rejection. As early as childhood, we have experienced being said no to. Mommy, I want ice cream. And the mommy would say, no. Mommy, I would like to go out with my friends. And the mommy would say, no, stay home. It goes up and up. Sometimes during our adulthood, we even experience like an unrequited love. Minahal mo siya, pero hindi kanya minahal. ang sakit. No? But if we look at our experiences of rejection, many times our rejection experience is nothing but a redirection. Redirection. Tinanggihan tayo sapagkat inaakay tayo ng Diyos sa mas mainam na sitwasyon. Tinanggihan ang pag-ibig mo, pero may nakilala kang mas mainam pala do sa minahal mo ng una. Sinabihan tayo nung bata tayo ng ating nanay, no to ice cream. Pero meron pala siyang inihahanda sa ating masarap na dinner. Look at your experience in the past. Your experience of rejection. And you will be surprised that many times the experience of rejection is nothing but a redirection. God is preparing us for something much, much better. I think that is one of the messages of the gospel, especially the passage from Psalm 18, quoted by the Lord. The stone that the builders rejected, the stone rejected. Ay, hindi pwede yan, no? Tapon mo na lang yan. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Alam po niyo yung cornerstone? Nung araw, wala namang semento, konkreto, bakal, wala naman yan, hindi ba? Kapag gagawa sila ng arko, no, halimbawa, pinto, arko, yan, katulad yan, mga arko, yung pinakagitna nun, yung gitnang bato, yun ang cornerstone. Sapagkat yun ang humahawak, no? Pag inalis niyo yung gitnang yon, yung buong arko babagsak. Yun ang pinakahuling inilalagay para suportahan ang arko. You see, a stone that was rejected has become a superstar. Many times, that is also experience. Our rejections are just preparations for something much better. On the other hand, our experience of rejections must also give us a kind of empathy, a sense of empathy. Ano ibig ko sabihin? Yung bang dahil sa nakaranas ka ng hindi magandang karanasan, na tinanggihan ka, dapat yon ay maging dahilan upang maunawaan natin ang ibang tao dahil alam natin ang kanilang pinagdadaanan. Minsan, may mga kasama kayo sa trabaho, ang bitter, no? Ang bitter. Unawain natin. Baka hindi siya niyakap ng kanyang nanay nung bata siya. Baka puro rejection ang naranasan niya. We who have experienced being rejected must show empathy to others. You know, sometimes, hindi natin maintindihan ang pamamaraan ng Diyos. Kaya, nagiging nagtatampo tayo, no? Nagiging yung bang negative ang pananaw natin sa buhay, nawawalan tayo ng pag-asa. Just remember, kapag tayo ay tinanggihan, isipin na lamang natin na merong mas mainam na naghihintay sa atin. Amen.
Please stand.
Reflecting upon the warning in the Gospel about the need to bear fruit, we place our request before God the Father, saying, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That church leaders may receive light, strength, and support in guiding the flock in times of difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the spirit of prayer in our families may be given attention so that our minds may be filled with the peace and joy that comes from God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in our own lives we may bear fruits of love, forgiveness, justice, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the aged, the lonely, and the sick may not lose heart in the midst of their trials and difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may find a place in God's eternal kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, your Son was the stone rejected. We accept him with all our hearts and confidently present our supplications to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We offer you sacrifice, O Lord, humbly praying that as you granted the blessed martyrs grace to die rather than sin, so you may bring us to minister at your altar in dedication to you alone, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, including Saint Charles Luanga and his companion martyrs, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," Look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. We have received this divine sacrament, O Lord, as we celebrate the victory of your holy martyrs. May what helped them to endure torment, we pray, make us, in the face of trials, it steadfast in faith and charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.